Good morning, aspirants. Today I'll be sharing some insights on IAS. The UPSC Civil Service Examination is popularly known nowadays as IAS examination. Today I'll be sharing a plan to crack it. A plan to crack UPSC Civil Service Examination 2020. This is Raghu with you. This is a brief about me. Coming to the topic of the discussion, a plan to crack UPSC Civil Service 2020. Your plan for UPSC Civil Service 2020 has to be integrated. What does this mean? It means your interview, your written examination, and your preliminary examination preparation should be integrated. All these should be prepared in an integrated way, not as discrete. In fact, the syllabus of all this is almost integrated. Say, for example, in UPSC mains Civil Service interview, your personality is tested. In interview, they test whether you have civil service values or not. They test whether you have civil service aptitude or not. Then, civil service values is a very important concept in the ethics paper. In your mains examination, civil service aptitude, what they test is very important component of your preliminary examination. In this way, the civil service examination, the different stages are integrated. So your preparation also should be integrated. You have to start your preparation keeping interview in mind. This is very easy, and you have to keep some few things in your mind throughout your preparation. This will have a very, very good impact on the examiner and also mains. Even when you are preparing for prelims, why is this so? Why you have to start your interview preparation from the beginning itself? The reason for this is, in interview, the civil service values, your personality is tested. These are the things which take very, very long time to change. So if there is any fine tuning that is needed, you have to start it now itself. Written examination is all about your writing skills, your expressions. These are the things which take a long time to develop. So you have preparations to start with interview, then mains, then preliminary examination. According to the latest timetable released by UPSC, you have got 210 days from 12th of this month. From 12th June 2020, you have got 210 days for the mains written examination. Interview days are not yet out. And for preliminary examination, you have got 114 days from 12th. And there's a gap of 96 days. You have to keep these things in mind before you plan. And you have to plan civil service preparation in three parts, which should be aligned with the date of the preliminary examination, the mains examination, and the interview. And this plan for cracking the UPSC examination is not same for all. As you all are aware, there are five different types of aspirants who will be writing the UPSC examination. Each of them need a different approach, a different strategy. It is not same for all. A person who has attended the interview already should follow a different strategy, different plan, different approach. When compared to a fresher. So keeping this thing in mind, the first type of aspirant is a fresher. A fresher is one who has not yet attended any civil service examination. A fresher's plan should be very, very different from other type of aspirants, because all other aspirants will have something common. That is, they have some experience with UPSC civil service examination, but the fresher is lacking that. He's not having any idea of how the examination will be because he has not faced. And also, as you all are aware, every year there will be nearly 80% of the aspirants who are not freshers. So this makes the approach and plan of a fresher to be different from the rest. Next, a person who has attended prelims, no matter how many times he has attended, but he has not cleared the prelims. Here, in this category, an aspirant might have taken the mains coaching, might have attended the test series, might have gone for mains answer writing, might have got himself enrolled into different things in the preparation, but he is not able to clear the prelims. So he should have a different plan. Then a person who has already written mains, means who has cleared the prelims, but he has not cleared the mains. Means to say that he has just written the mains written examination and he has not attended the interview. The next category where he has cleared the mains examination written, but he has not cleared the interview. Means he has attended the interview, but he has not got the service. And there is last category. Those who have cleared all the stages, that is civil service, mains interview part also. As you all are aware, almost all the successful candidates of the previous years who are non-IAS, they all will be writing again if they are willing and able. Means if they have attempt and if they think they should write. All the aspirants for non-IAS will be giving an attempt. So all these five types of aspirants will have different types of plans. So I have jotted down different plans for all these different types. And you take this as a blueprint and build your own plan and execute it. Since the date of interview is not been announced, we have to take the date of mains as one of the milestone. And our, as I said, our planning should have three parts based on the preliminary examination date, mains examination date, and interview. In this section, I'll be concentrating mainly on the first part, means how you have to prepare between 12/6/2020 to the preliminary date, that is 4th October. But whatever may be a thing, all these aspirants have to do certain things before the preliminary examination, because preliminary examination is the most important stage, because if you don't clear prelims, you won't be admitted to write the mains examination. So aspirants, whether they have cleared the mains, attended the interview, whether you are fresher, all of you should do certain things. All of you should cover some of the books, master some of the books, master some of the references. What are they? They are budget. Budget is the most important, the most authenticated, the latest available source, the latest and most authentic source available with respect to our society, our government, our country is budget. So you have to internalize budget. Next, you have to internalize India Yearbook. India Yearbook is a very good book where you have got almost all the topics, whether it may be prelims, mains or interview. It has got polity, geography, history, science and technology, India and world, all parts. Next is economic survey. So these three should be covered. Very, very important, because there is a flow in these three things. When you flow in these three things, and you have to maintain that flow. When you prepare, if you prepare budget, India Yearbook or the economic survey as discrete, it will be difficult for you and you cannot assimilate. So you have to take India Yearbook as the base, and you have to incorporate the topics, the elements, facts from economic survey and budget into it. Then you have to overimpose this India Yearbook to the syllabus of UPSC. By reading, by mastering these three, you will be having an integrated approach for mains, written mains examination, and also prelims for interview, written examination, and prelims. Let me explain this. Most of the people who are present in the interview panel, they will refer these three. Mains, most of the topics are covered in this. Say for example, budget, it's all about your policies, programs. It is all about the economy. India Yearbook, very, very important. In this, most of the mains topics are covered. Preliminary exam, most of the questions are coming from these three things. So if you master these things, I feel that nearly 20 to 30 questions you'll be getting in preliminary examination. And most of the topics in mains examination other than ethics will be covered in this general studies part, I mean to say. Then you may ask me a question, why? Why, whether a person who has attended interview or a fresher, why they have to concentrate on these three books? I am emphasizing, I am stressing on these three books because they are UPSC books. My dear friends, you may be well versed with this subject, you may master a subject, but if you are not referring the books which UPSC is referring, then the chances of you answering correctly will be very, very less. So these books have to be mastered, because they are being referred by UPSC. So these are UPSC books. UPSC is directly picking questions in prelims, mains, and interview from these books. If you have not mastered these books, please master them. If you have not mastered, your chances of clearing civil service examination are very less. I once again reiterate, please master these three books because they are UPSC books, because UPSC is asking questions from these books. If you don't master these books, your chances of clearing UPSC civil service examination are very, very less. Well, let me explain this in brief again. Most of the aspirants ask, sir, from where we have to start current affairs? From which year we have to start current affairs? If you read these three, budget, India Yearbook, and economic survey, 3 year current affairs will be covered. Budget for the upcoming year, India for this year, economic survey the previous year. So you'll be having a flow and you'll be having the current affairs required for 3 years. So current affairs means these three books. For this, you can add some things, but these are the basic book you have to refer. Then economy. Budget is full of economy. In India Yearbook, there are many chapters like basic economic data, finance, commerce, energy, which are directly related to economy. Economic survey is full of economy, Indian economic things, wherein part one explains some of the trends, some of the concepts, and part two explains the Indian economy completely. In fact, in prelims and also in mains, UPSC is directly picking questions from economic survey with respect to economy. Many students even ask, which are the important topics in economy? Please take the economic survey and just note down the content. Know the meaning of this content, terms which are given in this content. This is in fact the syllabus of your economy, from where you will be getting the questions. Very, very important, especially for prelims and mains, because they have been UPSC has been picking the questions directly from the economic survey. Environment. In your budget, there will be many schemes with respect to environment. In your India Yearbook, there is an exclusive chapter named Environment itself, where especially in the preliminary examination, they have been asking the questions. UPSC is picking some lines in the environment chapter of India Yearbook, and they have been asking questions. And in economic survey, in both the part one and part two, you have one or two chapters related to climate change, related to the environment, which are very, very important. Next, polity. Budget. What is budget? Budget is nothing but passing a financial bill. It involves the political process. In India Yearbook, you have a separate chapter named polity. So the polity section is also present. Then geography. In your India Yearbook, the first chapter, the land and the people, and in the fag end, the states, is full of geographical things. Questions are coming from this area also. Once again, I stress on this one, please master these three books. These are the three books which are game changers for you. In this period, that is before the preliminary examination, please master these three books. These are UPSC books. UPSC is directly picking questions from that. In this, a point of caution, India yearbook is not updated. Lot of things are not given, not a lot of things which are outdated are given. I will explain that later when I speak about India yearbook. Then in my next session, I'll be telling you a detailed plan specially for freshers, how they have to prepare, how they have to plan for the civil service examination. After that, I'll be explaining a plan for each of these categories. If you have any queries you want me to answer, please comment your queries below in the comment section. I'll be very happy to answer those things. Till then, take care, happy reading, enjoy your preparation. Thank you.